Please welcome to the stage, Miss Georgia, Kelsey Hollis.
Meantime, how many parents do we have in the audience? I should say parents of girls that are competing. I hope she's not a parent. Well, I hope you guys are excited. I think it's always really special. My mom used to say that she loved being able to kind of just sit back and relax, but that it was super nerve-wracking. So I hope that you guys are excited for your daughters. They all seem excited back here. I've seen a couple of smiles, a little bit of anxiousness, but I think that's important. You gotta be anxious to know that it's important enough to you. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Now, I have the honor of introducing our MC for this evening's competition, Ms. Chelsea Paulding. Chelsea is a forever alumni of the University of West Georgia, graduating with the class of 2019, receiving her Bachelor of Science degree in Social and Behavioral Health with a minor in Women's Studies and certificates in Social Diversity and Social Services. Her time in the West was also dedicated to being Miss West Georgia in 2020, serving the community and representing with grace for 2 years. Ms. Paulding furthered her studies and graduated with her master's in public health with a concentration in health management from Augusta University. where she also continued her journey through the Miss America organization as Miss Augusta University 2022. Miss Paulding is now working as a program manager with the Georgia Statewide AHEC Network and Morehouse School of Medicine to further wellness within our communities. Her love for the Miss America organization continues through service and uplifting young women by joining the Miss West Georgia Scholarship Competition Board. She looks forward to adding another beautiful young lady to the family. With that being said, let's welcome your MC for tonight's program, Chelsea Paulding.
Doing tonight? Pretty good. Awesome. The Miss University of West Georgia Scholarship Competition is a Miss America preliminary, and we will be following the Miss America system rules as closely as possible. To this effect, I would like to remind you that no flash photography or videotaping is allowed during tonight's event. And we further remind you to please silence all electronic devices. Thank you so much for your cooperation. Now you have the opportunity to vote for your favorite candidate to receive the People's Choice Award. The candidate with the most votes will be recognized at the end of the competition. There will be one vote per person. You can place your votes until the last portion of the competition. So you better get in those votes because I'm sure ladies will like your votes. Before we begin our show, I want to introduce you to the people who will be selecting this year's winners. These five judges have their work cut out for them, but when you hear each one's credentials, you'll know this panel is up for the task. I will introduce three judges now and then the other two later this evening. Our first judge is Miss Betsy Grisham. Wave your hand, Miss Betsy. Miss Betsy is a successful entrepreneur in the social occasion fashion industry. Her gowns made famous and worn by Miss Georgia, Betty Cantrell, who later on went on to win Miss America 2015. When Betsy is not focused on the fashion industry, she loves to pursue her philanthropic ambitions, such as volunteering to feed over 500 people during the Thanksgiving holiday, becoming a certified judge for the Miss Georgia, or leading the Carrollton, Georgia chapter of A Night to Shine, which was started by 10 TiVo Foundation to celebrate people with special needs. Volunteer servantship gives Betsy great joy in assisting others. She lives in Carrollton and with her wonderful husband, Bart Grisham, and their fur baby, Izzy. Please welcome our very first judge, Miss Betsy Grisham. Next, we have our judge number two, Miss Vidalia Turner. Vidalia Turner is a native of Atlanta, Georgia, and a lifelong educator. She resides in Stone Mountain, Georgia. She has held various positions in Teaching Union, the Atlanta Federation of Teachers. Vidalia currently serves as a president of the Georgia Federation of Teachers and the Atlanta Federation of Teachers. Recently, she launched a video podcast called Let's Talk, designed to educate the public in depth on issues that affect their daily lives. She also has another video podcast where she gives her opinion or states what is going on at the time called Georgia Now. Vidalia became a teacher because her father desired for her to do so and because she respected and loved her teachers so much. Please give a round of applause for judge number two, Miss Vidalia Turner. Judge number three, Miss Samika Samuels. Samika Samuels currently serves as the educational consultant for Makata Challenge. In this role, she is responsible for planning professional development for teachers in Prince George's County in Maryland. She also serves as the National Youth Summit Director. Before this role, she was an assistant principal at Campbell High School in Smyrna, Georgia. Before that, she served as a high school, middle school, and elementary school teacher. Ms. Samuels' professional journey started on at University of West Georgia's campus, where she learned how to develop valuable skills as a leader and active community member. After graduation from UWG, Samika joined the United States Army. As a parent of two young adults, she continues to serve the community of Powder Springs. Please give a round of applause for Judge Number 3, Ms. Samika Samuels. By now, I know the tension is starting to bubble up, so we are going to ask that our 2023 candidates go ahead and get ready. We have our first phase of competition, which is the on-stage question and social impact. Earlier today, each candidate competed in private interviews with our panel of judges. Candidates took part in a 10-minute interview. Private interview counts for 35% of the candidate's score. This gives you a little better understanding of what the judges saw in their private interviews. We're going to bring back our candidates at this time for their on-stage interview. I will individually ask each candidate a question written by one of our judges. The candidate will have 20 seconds to answer that question, and the judges are looking to see how each candidate handles herself in front of a large crowd, which is quite different from being in front of five judges in a private interview. Judges will also determine if the candidate does indeed answer the question that is asked, how well each young lady phrases her response, and following the question and answer phase, each candidate will then present their social impact pitch. This will better understand her platform of choice. The candidate has up to 20 seconds to explain her social impact initiative. This recognizes that Miss America spends most of her time talking about her social impact initiative, promoting Miss Georgia and the Miss America organization, and also discussing current issues. This phase of competition is now worth 15% of their overall scoring. As we start tonight's phase of competition, we will start with candidate number 1, Jasmina Walker. Jasmina, your question this evening is from Judge Number 1, Ms. Betsy Grisham. You mentioned you love to read. Why is reading important to elementary students?
I believe reading builds a foundation for every other subject. There's nothing you can do without being able to read something. When we go into the real world, you have to be able to read job contracts, and so being able to read is such a fundamental thing for our youth.
Thank you. You may now move into your social impact pitch.
According to the National Center for Education Statistics, the teacher turnover rate is 16%. This means every year, a school will lose 3 out of every 20 teachers. With my social impact initiative, Equipping Our Schools, my goal is to lessen teacher burnout. Educators build the foundation for all other professions. Let's give them the respect they deserve.
Jasmina Walker. Candidate number 2 is Ms. Ariana Perlow. Ms. Ariana, your question was prepared by Judge Number 2, Ms. Vanilla Turner. You mentioned in your interview that UWG is phasing out real estate as a major or a minor. Why is the study of real estate so important?
The study of real estate is so important because we, as Americans, we have to have a place to live. So that is why real estate is important. We have to have businesses. We buy commercial property. We buy luxury property. So real estate is very important.
Thank you. You may now move into your social impact pitch.
there is no excuse for abuse. I will use my superpowers in social media marketing and public relations to be a catalyst for changing how we view and respond to domestic violence. 1 in 3 women and 1 in 4 men have experienced abuse. Using social media platforms, I will help educate the student body on how to help raise awareness.
Scientist, so I can clean up the crimes around the world.
may now move into your social impact pitch.
There are a lot of children who have been bullied, including myself, and that's why I want to make a change around the different schools. Keep the peace, fight against bullying.
Inside and outside of the USA?
I would say the pros to manufacturing inside the USA is beyond phenomenal because all of the items that we would sell in store would be made in the US, and a lot of customers love when items are made in the US. A con would be if your items are made outside of the US, shipping, cost, manufacturing may take some extra time and add some extra cost to your items that you sell in store due to imports and exports taxes.
Thank you. We move into your social impact pitch.
Growing up, I always struggled finding friends, feeling confident, getting out of my comfort zone, and just knowing that someone was there always supporting me. We still see this in kids today throughout schools. That is why it is my mission to support these kids and empower them through their faith. Let them know they have a loving father that's here to support them, provide for them, and lead the way for them. If I could just impact one kid through faith and the gospel, my mission would be done, while the Lord does the rest of the work.
Thank you, ladies, and thank you, judges. I think we can all agree that these candidates are intelligent, charismatic, and drop-dead gorgeous. Those outfits were beautiful. Now I would like to introduce the last two remaining judges. Our fourth judge tonight is Michael W. Davis. Michael W. Davis serves on the University of West Georgia Alumni Association Board of Directors, board member of Mosaic Georgia, and the chairman of the Accreditation Committee for the Chi Pi Fraternity. Michael holds a PhD in education from Iowa State University, a Master's of Science degree in Professional Counseling from Georgia State University, and a Bachelor's of Science degree in Early Childhood Education from the University of West Georgia. Michael has served as GUIDE's Associate Executive Director of Prevention since August 2018. In this role, Michael is responsible for oversight of all GUIDE's prevention strategies, activities, and campaigns. He has presented on the local, state, and national levels on leadership, education, prevention, and social justice issues. Please welcome Mr. Michael W. Davis, our judge number four. And the final member of our judges panel is Cassidy Nelson. Woo! Cassidy Nelson. Cassidy Nelson serves as the Director of Housing at the University of West Georgia and has a passion for seeing students thrive. Cassidy's passion for pageants and scholarship began at the age of 5 when she began competing in pageants, having held several titles throughout her competition years. She now enjoys coaching her daughter, who competes locally in youth pageants. Please give it up for our judge number 5, Cassidy Nelson. I think it's safe to say that although the judges have one of the hardest jobs here tonight, the competition auditors have one of the busiest. Their responsibility is to tally the judges' scores to determine our overall winners. I'll start with Holly Saylors. Holly Saylors is the CFO of the University of West Georgia's 3 affiliated foundations and the Executive Director of Advancement Services. Prior to joining the university, she worked in public accounting, consulting, and manufacturing. Holly is a graduate of the Georgia Institute of Technology and a Georgia licensed CPA. Holly resides in Carrollton with her husband,
This is Auditor Holly Saylors. Our final auditor for the evening is Kate Theobald. Kate is an Assistant Director of Alumni and Constituent Engagement at the University of West Georgia. She earned her AA in Secondary Education from Middle Georgia College in 2006. Her BA in English from UWG was in 2009, and her MED in Higher Education Administration for Georgia Southern University was in 2016. She currently is pursuing an ED degree in Higher Education Administration at UWG, where she's researching burnout and turnover among women working in higher education. She is immediate past president of the Georgia Undergraduate Research Collective, and she is the events committee chair for the Middle Georgia State University Alumni Board. Kate is an educator and lifelong learner who enjoys working with students, alumni, as they engage with the university. She is passionate about women's leadership and goal setting. Please get up for our other auditor, Katie Theobald. Thank you all for your valuable time, and we truly appreciate it and cannot wait to see who our new title holder will be. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss Carroll County teen, Ava Smith. She will be performing tonight for us for your musical.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was candidate number one, Jasmina Walker. Our next candidate comes to us performing an original monologue called Walking in Heels. Here is candidate number two, Ariana Perlow.
To walk like a lady, sometimes in life, situations are going to occur. But you must remember that you cannot go anywhere without your shoes. My mother used to ask me, baby, where are your shoes? Your faith. Your shoes are your faith and you need them for this journey. So, let's start with posture. Shoulders back, head high, and walk heel to toe. That's it, balance. And if you give the girl the right shoes, she will conquer the world. Marilyn Monroe said. And Maya Angelou said, pretty women wonder where my secret lies. I'm not cute or built to suit a fashion model size. But when they start to ask me, they think I'm telling lies. I said it's in the span of my arms, the spine of my hips, the stride of my step, and the curl of my lips. I'm a woman, phenomenally. Phenomenal woman, that's me. Now, here we go again. Shoulders back, head high, and walk heel to toe. That's it. Now, you'll never forget how to walk in your shoes, faithfully.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That was your candidate number two, Ariana Perlow. Performing the monologue, Elle Woods' Speak Up America, originally performed by Reese Witherspoon in 2003, Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer comedy, Legally Blonde 2. Please welcome candidate number three, Caroline Ott.
I'm here today to talk about something that is at the highest importance of every American. My hair. You see, there's a salon in Beverly Hills, and it's so beautiful and so fancy, but like impossible to get into. I mean, unless you're Julia Roberts or one of the girls from Friends, you could just forget it. But one day, they called me. I was gonna get my chance to sit in one of those sacred beauty chairs. I was so excited. But then, the colorist gave me Brassy Brigitte, and this shampoo girl washed my hair with Spiraling Perm Solution instead of Color Intensive Moisturizing Shampoo and Conditioner. Lastly, the stylist gave me a bob with bangs. It was wrong. It was all wrong for me. And at first, I was furious. I was so mad until I realized my anger was misdirected. I had sat there and I had witnessed the injustice that they did to my hair, but I didn't get involved in the process and I didn't use my voice. Frankly, I just didn't believe in myself. Needless to say, I learned my lesson, but I also learned that one honest voice can be louder than a crowd. I know that if we lose our voice or if we let those who speak on our behalf compromise our voice, well then, this country's in for a really bad haircut. So, speak up, America. Speak up.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was candidate number three, Caroline Ott. Entertaining us this evening with a vocal rendition of Lift Me Up by Rihanna, this is candidate number four, Michaela McCoy.
Close, safe and sound.
boy. Singing Journal by Cassie J. Here is candidate number 5, Ayana McCovey.
Dream it anyway. Tonight, I have one question for you. Is EC better or Z6?
Z6!
It's that Fried Chicken Wednesday, isn't it?
Yeah!
There you go. Go Wolves, right? I love it. For the people that aren't UWG or Wolves natives, that's our dining halls that were here. So Z6 was always my go-to, especially since I was over in Arbor Hall. And so just a quick walk down whenever I wanted some fried chicken, hang out with my friends. But being here was just kind of bringing back all those good memories too, from being in the campus center and going to the Starbucks. Did you guys get any new restaurants since 2019? Sushi, Mexican, okay. I know over by the bookstore when I was here, that little area was like vacant for a good little minute. So I'm glad to see that they've actually put something. But the bookstore was always my favorite too, going to get all the West Georgia t-shirts. Now my fiance has stolen all of my West Georgia t-shirts, so I call him an honorary UWG alumni, even though he's been to a different college, but we love to see him, right? How are you guys enjoying the evening so far? Can we give it up for our ladies? On the count of three, I want you to scream out your contestant that you're cheering for. 1, 2, 3.
Yeah!
Absolutely beautiful. It takes a lot of courage to come up on this stage, although I know firsthand how it is so grueling to get ready for this competition, but I want to commend all the ladies for taking time out of their day with their busy schedules in order to be up here and represent the university so graciously. All right, so I know we're itching to get on with the rest of the show, so now let's continue with the task at hand, selecting a new title holder and having the opportunity to compete in Columbus, Georgia for Miss Georgia Competition 2023. The candidates have demonstrated poise while answering questions in front of hundreds of people, and now we get to watch them walk across the stage and present their grace and poise in their lovely evening wear. So we are going to move on to the red carpet and showcase them in the most elegant phase of the competition. They will be judged on poise, grace, and style. It is not about the cost of the gown, but important but how the candidates wear the gown. The red carpet phase of the competition counts 15% of their overall scoring. And we will begin with Jasmina Walker, candidate number one.
Please.
sophomore, majoring in elementary education. She entertained us this evening with a lyrical to see things differently. And she comes to us tonight from her hometown of Carrollton, Georgia. Ladies and gentlemen, that's candidate number one, Jasmina Walker. Candidate number two, Ariana Perlow. Ariana is majoring in mass communications with a double minor of real estate and psychology. During the talent phase of competition, she performed an original monologue, Walking in Heels. She currently resides in Washington, Georgia. Ladies and gentlemen, your candidate number two, Ariana Perlow. Candidate number three is next. She is Caroline Ott. Caroline is a junior majoring in speech language pathology. And she performed a monologue, Speak Up America, in the talent portion of the show this evening. Caroline's hometown is Carrollton, Georgia. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Caroline Ott. Next we have candidate number four, Miss Michaela. Candidate number six, Miss Kenna Kay. freshman majoring in business management and marketing. In the talent portion of tonight's competition, Kenna presented a monologue about sewing. And her hometown is Athens, Georgia. Ladies and gentlemen, that is candidate number 6, Ms. Kenna K. And this completes the evening fair competition, and in fact, that completes all our phases of competition. Please join me in congratulating each of the candidates for gracefully completing each segment of tonight's competition. Before we continue, I want to take a moment and recognize a very special group of people. For the parents of the candidates, you work unselfishly with and for your daughters so hard that they compete, that they can participate and compete in a competition such as this one. You remain quietly in the shadows so that they may shine. Tonight we want to turn the spotlight on you and offer our most sincere thanks. Will all the parents of the candidates please stand, and audience, please give them a heartfelt round of applause. Individuals and groups who have supported us in with their time, their talents, and their services. Many have also offered their financial support as well. We would like to thank some of our sponsors. The first, the University of West Georgia, Go Wolves. The Miss West Georgia and Miss Carroll County Scholarship Competition. Sam's House Barbecue, Inc. And a Fair to Remember for sponsoring this lovely gown that I have on tonight. And Vexum Medium, Inc. And a special thanks to the Don't Be a Bully Foundation and Rocking My Glory for their donations. Please give them all a great round of applause for supporting the Miss West Georgia organization. There were sign-in sheets placed at the registration for title holders and special guests to sign in, and we would like to spotlight them, and we appreciate your support in coming out tonight. If you are a local title holder for the Miss Georgia organization, if you could please stand and be recognized, we would love to give you a round of applause for showing your support today. Any local directors, any boards, or who may be visiting, and we would like for you to stand and be recognized as well. Although the crowning of Miss University of West Georgia is just moments away, it is only the competition of the evening that comes to a close. The memories of this night will forever be etched in the minds and the hearts of each of these young ladies backstage tonight. And all of who offer their support tonight, we thank you and we hope you have those lasting memories as well. One final announcement before we introduce our winners. We respectfully ask that only the parents of the winners be allowed on stage at the end of the competition. We thank you for your cooperation and your understanding. If the judges are ready, let's bring back our candidates onto the stage. Oh, well, we're gonna wait just a second because we have our lovely Miss Georgia, Miss Kelsey Hollis, back to the stage. Please give her a warm welcome.
Are we on? There we go. All right, we're back. And I think that's a beautiful thing. And I'm not sure how long you guys have been rehearsing and preparing for this in terms of a collective group. But find the beauty in the process. There's only one girl that can walk away with the title tonight. But like I said, I've gotten to spend some time with each of you ladies backstage for a little bit. And even just in that short period of time, I've been able to kind of pick out the beautiful things about each and every single one of you ladies. And I think when you use this experience as an opportunity to grow, and not just learn more about the ladies that are around you, but also more about yourself in ways that you can improve outside of this pageant and outside of this organization, that's when you really are able to win. And it at that point, doesn't even matter who walks around with the title, although it is, like I said, a special thing. So yeah, I hope that each of you ladies understand that and recognize that you're so deserving of being up here. And whoever wins that title is in a very blessed position, but each of you ladies have something extremely special to offer. I'm sure every single person in the audience that is watching you guys and here supporting you guys, and even the ladies backstage, recognize that as well. But you know, it's one thing for other people to be proud of you, another thing for you to be proud of you. That's what it comes down to. So yeah, I just want to wish you guys good luck.
For those beautiful words, and please give her another round of applause for her amazing performance. All right, now if our judges are ready, let's bring all of our candidates back onto the stage. Begin by by announcing the preliminary awards, starting with People's Choice Award winner. Our People's Choice of winner goes to candidate number 4, Ms. Michaela McCoy. Yeah! In Carrollton, Georgia. This recipient will receive a $100 cash award. And the Best Evening Gown Award goes to candidate number 4, Ms. McKayla. In Carrollton, Georgia. The recipient will receive a $100 cash award. And the Best Interview Award goes to candidate number 1, Jasmina Walker.
Great night and stay safe. Thank you.